earlier from here. I mean, literally, we were standing underneath the awning of this building, and when things started shaking and rattling, we quickly bolted away from here because things were shaking so violently, Megan and Mark. We weren't quite sure if things were going to come down collapsing on top of us. We've actually been looking at these support pillars, making sure there's no cracks in them, no seriously foundation issues. But you might remember we came live at 4 o'clock, and we showed a part of the ceiling that had come collapsing down. Well, since that magnitude 5.4 aftershock rocked this area, even more of the ceiling has now come down. And you see even more of that insulation up above just hanging down there. Just the damage here just exasperating, getting more and more significant as the morning goes on. Since we've arrived here about 30 minutes ago, we've now experienced 2 significant aftershocks. And the people have lived it here since yesterday's 6.4 that started all this off. They've had to go through more than 100 of these other aftershocks. Here's a sample. Have a look at this. And that, of course, is from the 6.4 magnitude quake that began all of this scary situation here in Ridgecrest. You know, some of the worst damage we've seen was at a mobile home park. There's a few trailers there that were knocked off their foundations. One of them looks like it's almost going to fall over. A few shops in the area suffered very, very significant damage. These are all the shops that have a lot of items on the shelves. So you might imagine things like liquor stores, Walmarts, convenience stores, you know, places suffering a lot of broken merchandise. Power outages are still a big issue here in the Ridgecrest area this morning. Underground power lines have been severed in places, leaving a number of people in the dark. The cleanup and the repairs, they've been going on ever since things stopped violently shaking. A few roads have had to be patched up. One in particular ripped in half all the way across the concrete section of the street, and it was actually wide enough to cause serious accident. So the crews had to move in and fill those in as quick as they could. A state of emergency has now been declared for Ridgecrest after the 6.4 rocked the Mojave Desert area yesterday morning, beginning at about 10:30 a.m. If there's one good thing we can report, is that there are no serious injuries that have happened because of this quake. But this earthquake, it is the strongest to strike California in some 20 years. And for those of us who experienced it, it really felt like it. Have a listen.
Everything in my house had fallen just about on the floor because the house was just shaking really hard.
Yeah, it was scary.
Yeah, and we probably felt 10 or 12 aftershocks that we had to go outside.
Yeah,
they were shaking that bad. And then we heard that it could get even worse, that the aftershocks get worse. And my kids said, "Mom, you have to get out."
You can understand why a lot of people don't want to stay in their homes. They don't want to stay in this town or anywhere near it as long as these aftershocks are still happening, frightening everyone. You know, a few places are messier than others after the quake hit. This year, this is the Ridgecrest Public Library. Thousands of books were thrown off the shelves when things started shaking back and forth. Library officials are now asking for the public's help. They want volunteers to come and give them a hand picking up all these books and reorganizing everything. They're going to actually meet in the public library parking lot in Ridgecrest at 9 o'clock, and then if there's any extra volunteers, they're going to go around and try to see if they can't help other people, businesses, and even some museums across the street. Back out here today. Again, this is another live look at just some of the damage inside a laundromat here in Ridgecrest. Today, stores are open. The gas stations are operating. Life should go on as normal as long as there's not another massive quake that rocks this area. But still, nothing quite feels like normal for the residents here because these aftershocks are just one reminder after another of the terror that really struck this area less than 24 hours ago. That's the latest here in Ridgecrest. We're going to stay live and bring you more updates as the morning continues. I'm Steve Kuzj, KTLA 5 News. Megan Marcus, I'll send it back to you.
All right, Steve. Thanks.